Yes, what is up, my fellow Monarch Monsters? You know, you already know what time it is. It's a brand new episode of Monarch Legacy of Monsters. Will the real May please stand up? Clearly, we're going to learn a little bit more about our Kiersey Clemens character, May. What is she running from? I don't know. But I have a feeling we're going to find out tonight, which makes me all the more excited. Did Tim survive from episode 6? All these questions we have, and we're coming down to the final few episodes of season 1 of Monarch. Hopefully we get a season 2. A lot going on tonight. If you haven't, you know, seen on social media, a lot trending: Monarch, Rebel Moon, Sel Snyder versus Netflix. It's a lot going on. But you already know, we're keeping to the schedule. We're going to be watching with you guys Monarch Legacy of Monsters on Apple TV Plus. So if you haven't already, please pull up your Monarch Legacy of Monsters. Make sure it's on previously on Monarch Legacy of Monsters so that you guys are ready to go with us. We're going to breeze through this, guys, because while I'm very excited for Monarch and to see what the answers they give us this week, and discuss it this weekend with you guys, Rebel Moon also just came out on Netflix. Zack Snyder's new space odyssey film that is just going to be absolutely fire. The trailers have me hyped as well. Like, it just, every day is a good day. So literally, we're going to watch this, talk about it real quick, and then I'm hopping off to go watch Rebel Moon with the Wonder Wife. Because we're going to blow up Netflix just like we're blowing up Apple TV Plus. We're spreading the love on all the streaming services. So, guys, to go through it all quickly right now, follow us on our social media pages like TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, at the underscore Bat Channel, or if you're on Facebook, at Holy Bat Channel. I feel like I'm selling like horses or something, like 35, 35, 45, 100, 105. Let's go. And then, as always, if you want to help our channel even more, like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you never miss an episode. Help us get to 3K subs because we can't do it without you, especially you, Replay Crew. Help us. We're so close, so freaking close to hitting our end of the year goal. I know we can't do it without you guys. So, Battalion, you know what to do. And guys, as always, with our future shows, our little slate coming up, we have all of our discussion videos of Monarch throughout this season. Definitely check it out. We came up with some fire theories that have been proven true so far. So we're on a hot streak. But our next show, for all those who are asking what's going on with Rebel Moon, we will be watching that tomorrow night. First, it'll be my second time watching it. But I believe my best co-host, Super Bro Corey, it will be his first time watching it. So you'll get his live reaction. But for me, I just really wanted to be focused all in on Rebel Moon and absorb it all as I can, because it looks cool. It looks so freaking cool. So I'll be setting that stream up tonight right after the show. So make sure you guys are ready for that and setting your reminders. And without further ado, let's go ahead and bring out our fire Monarch Monsters panel. Ladies and gentlemen, Super Bro Corey and Koj, how's it going, guys?
Woo! Let's go!
Let us go. You know, you already know. Guys, are you excited for tonight's episode? Oh, I think it's Koj on mute.
Koj.
Whoa! Hey. You didn't get my full vocal in the beginning then. No, I just hope we get more of the real Godzilla stand-up than me, you know.
Godzilla stand-up?
Or more Godzilla standing up.
I like that. Any predictions before the show starts?
More Godzilla standing up.
I really want
more Godzilla.
You just want that's your prediction too. You're just, it's not only what you want, but you just predicting they can have more Godzilla. I like it.
Yeah, because we got up from the ground. We gotta continue.
Stand up.
I like it. Super Bro, your thoughts? Any predictions?
Bro, before we get to the predictions, I have to say what up to the chat tonight, bro. There are so many people here that said, yeah, you know what? We can hold off on Rebel Moon. We want Godzilla content first. And we thank you and you out there, you too, and all of you. Thank you so much, everybody. We appreciate you coming in. We want to give a huge shout out to hashtag Restore the Snyderverse Guy, Bat Fanatic, Wayne Enterprises, Being Classified, Monarch Guys Only said, hello, everyone. I'm looking forward to rubbing in as well. But first, Monarch. We got Atomic Kaiju 1954, Akio Lee. We have Kaiju Crazy, Craig Rowan. We have Keen Donkey Kong, chest pounding himself all the way in town. And you know our girl Oracle's in town. She says, hi, peeps, skipping Rebel Moon for this tonight. Thank you, Oracle. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Red Hood Outlaws says, what up, gang? Trevor H is in the house. Beyond the Night is also doing the same thing. We appreciate you, Beyond the Night, as well. Everybody that's here, we appreciate you. The Butler, we have the Batman Who Laughs, Batwoman, Nine Lives in Hell here. Terry Kelly with a hashtag Rebel Moon. Mistress of Mayhem, you guys are true Godzilla fans. You're absolutely right. Joker's Wild, choosing Monarch over Rebel Moon. We appreciate you. Atomic Kaiju 1954, I think I said already. Wayne Enterprises, did we say? Oracle Clock Tower kind of blew my mind here. Imagine if Zach had directed a Godzilla film or a Kaiju film altogether. Ooh. Man, what? That blows my mind
that
out.
That would be insane.
Damn, that'd be...
Right? Can you imagine that?
Dude, I would be so down for that. Yeah.
Yeah, we got the Batman Last. We got TJ in the house. May sold out.
What's up, TJ?
Real Godzilla stand up. We are bringing in the fire for sure. We appreciate you all so much. Thank you for being here. As far as predictions, I like May. I do like May a lot. So I'm hoping that this storyline does her justice. That's all I'm hoping for. I love her as a person. I loved her in Zack Snyder's Justice League. I'm hoping that her storyline does us justice. But yes, I think you are right, Trey. If there's people here today, right now, with us, and if they're not going to watch it, I might skip Rebel Moon until tomorrow to enjoy it with all of y'all.
Ooh, that dedication, dog.
Right? Man, and this is why I love the Battalion community. You guys have stuck with us so much, and I appreciate that. Like, you guys know, I'm not going to lie, I was torn tonight. Because I was like, man, Rebel Moon's coming out early. This is like one of my most anticipated films of 2023. But I'm also about consistency, and I don't want to let down our Godzilla community, because you guys have really bumped up this channel to the next level, and I just thank you guys so much. And I know how important it is to just keep it with the schedule. You guys are in a routine,
I remember. Yeah, I remember talking to Trey. He was like, oh man, Rebel Moon's next week. What are we going to do? I was like, we're going to watch Monarch Legacy of Monsters. That's what we're going to do.
Yeah, buddy. I love what Mistress of Mayhem says here. We're going to do it all. You already know. Guys, hopefully you are all ready. And we're going to get started here pretty soon. Let us know in the chat if you're ready.
And we're going to get started. It's raining over here. Super Corey. When you went all like that, there's huge thunder and lightning. I was like, what the heck?
That's the power of Zeus. I love it.
Daijuzen,
yes. Guys, we've been watching some Super Sentai with our boy Kojay. That's some videos going to be coming out soon. I can't wait. We've been having a great time with that. A great time. I'm already looking forward to the next time we watch the next set of episodes. So it's going to be good.
Yeah, I'm just happy and blessed. Thank you. Hope you all tune into that.
Yeah. Corey, what's the chat saying? We ready?
We ready.
All right. You already know. Here we go. Coming down in 3, 2, 1. Play.
I got my wish. It's a recap, doesn't count.
Oracle's open. Please be alive, Tim. I know Crochet's rooting for him to
die. I'm all right. I'm all right if he doesn't. Yeah, you can stay lean down a bit. Oh, dang! Kojay with Apple the L. Original.
Are you there already?
Oh, he's just coming out of the stand.
Holy Boba Fett, Batman.
Oh my gosh. Dude, he's getting up exactly like Godzilla did, which is kind of cool. A shot.
Mm.
Algeria. Because he hates his kids. Damn.
No. Oh, I was thinking maybe she got captured finally. Used her card.
Poor me. Well, she's freaking out. Flashback time. Oh. Oh boy.
I kind of dig that. Just being blunt about it. It's so big.
Where are you guys at right now?
I got 314, 315.
Yeah, I'm at 316 right now.
Okay.
Same.
It's going through the opener.
Yeah. Music by Leopold. Edited by Mark.
Is this theme song a little different?
I'm not sure.
You know, sometimes a show will do that. They'll have a different theme song. And
Ahsoka did that a lot, I think, right? With the opener, they kind of.
Oh, yeah?
Or no, or is it Andor? Andor messed with the Andor, opener theme a lot.
Yeah. Oh, I like
it. Dude, that bums me out that Andor is not going to be next year.
Pushed back.
Yeah.
As long as it's not canceled, pushback, I could
plan
to live a little bit longer. That's all.
Oh, she gone.
And a clue. That's a clean bathroom. It's like Seattle.
There's a clothes under there. Yeah. How did they get out of the desert so quickly? Very good question.
Train.
I was just joking about Seattle.
Calling me Nathan, she's a dick. What is a teacher? Do you know?
I have no idea. I was thinking it could potentially be something with Apex. I don't know. Oh, yeah. See, even Wayne Enterprise thinks Apex.
Was there a big swamp in the background?
Created.
Wait, did she leave Monarch, or is she still spying on Monarch? It's like he doesn't buy it. I don't mind Tim. All right, Tim's the link to where their pop is at.
Thank you so much, Oracle Spot Guard. Don't forget to hit that like, people. We appreciate it.
Really like the soundtrack,
right?
We're back at Outpost 88 again, huh?
Hey, finally we see where she was, where she went. She was in the desert.
Yeah. Think outpost in Utah, right, Corey?
Yep. Makes sense why she's into remote work. She's a little awkward, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, did she put something in there?
What is this?
She put a virus?
No, I
think it's like Jurassic Park, dude.
It is. Oh, they're coming in to take over. This is a takeover, bro. Somebody within Monarch? Yes. Are we going to kill them all? Or? Yes. Hostile takeover. Oh my God. Yes.
Ah, dang, she didn't see her.
Stop her. Stop her. Let's go, Shaw. Take over, baby. Put in the chat hashtag Shaw Takeover.
Dang. Shaw Takeover.
Wow, that's amazing.
Huh. All right, Tim won me over. And they won't toss.
Oracle. Hashtag Tim won over Koji.
Aura?
Aura.
Isn't that
tonight? Wow. This was the stars align, yo.
Right?
With Cora, Trey.
You know, season two, the second series of Avatar: Last Airbender.
Mm.
What, Legend of Korra? Great show.
Like it. We don't hand out participation trophies here.
They'll probably be gone before Monarch gets there.
Yep. I wonder what that is.
Like where?
Oracle. TJ said, by the way, ain't that Cyborg's mama or am I tripping? Good question, TJ.
You look that up.
No, I don't think it's her.
It didn't look like her to me. Yeah, I agree, Koji.
Oh, they're trying to power up Godzilla, maybe?
But those didn't look like nukes. I wonder if they're trying to close the Hollow Earth portals. Like collapse them with the bombs.
Because they know that those weapons won't do against Godzilla.
Yeah, and Shaw would know better than anybody.
Oh.
Damn it, it actually is.
Crazy, he didn't chime in on what she likes.
Right.
That's so like Beethoven in the end when they were following.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know why that scared me for a second.
Oh my goodness.
Apex. Oh, she's going to cut a corner. And we're going to see that hallway with the picture. Yeah, the art looks like even Sierra Leone, maybe.
She did something to their systems.
You think so?
Everybody's looking for her at work. She messed something up on purpose or...
Oh, they just turned on that lava lamp. She's not going to tell her.
Yeah, she's doing something. TJ said, what was Apex's claim to fame? Neuroscience, with being a major experimental project. Neurology for the brain.
This could be like a subsidiary business.
Oh, great. For Mecha Godzilla, maybe?
I mean, but at this point, this would be almost 2.5 years ago. So, wait.
What if this is linked to the villain in the new movie coming out?
Actually, it might be.
You know, Godzilla?
Yeah, it could be. Based off that scene right there with the monkeys. Or the apes, sorry. Walter.
Oh, wow. We're gonna kill you.
Holy hell, that is it.
Mecha Godzilla?
It's totally it. She said when she's like, you know, why does it matter? Doesn't Walter have enough money in his kit cushions? She's talking about Walter Simmons, who owns Apex. That's exactly what they're building.
And that's why it's important for Tim to follow along with this. Because he needs to tell Monarch. Yay. Is this TPP?
Probably. But what if it was used in a way to control society, to pull the alarm so that they could do secret experiments? That type of power could be really abused.
I'd abuse the hell out of it.
So that's how they get in.
He put a fake alarm, Tim. You son of a bitch, Tim. TPP, folks. Everybody stay calm.
That's exactly what it is. Holy shit.
Very cool.
The next villain.
You're welcome. Who's the greatest Godzilla detective? Jay, who's the greatest Godzilla detective?
All of us.
Swear to me! Man, her character is so complicated.
She's going to have to do great it. If they like continue this into season two, how awesome.
Look at those snacks. Oh, they got them corn pops? Or those?
That's what she said like that. Yes. She made that name up on the spot.
Full circle on the Trevor H. Thank you.
Oh, damn.
Oh, dang.
Huh.
E6974, what's that?
Korra. Oh, Korra. Right, Ralph. Damn.
Kate.
Damn. Yeah, ain't that the truth, right? Nobody has anything to stand for. You know, allegiance has changed so much of the show.
Mm.
Except for here, everybody. I stand with Shaw.
Shaw's the only consistent one.
Yep. Yeah, you know, he could be, yeah. And Kate. maybe.
I don't think Monarch's working with AT. I think they know they're an issue. Don't you get the vibe, Trey?
Well, it would appear that Monarch was oblivious to what Apex was doing in Godzilla versus Kong, so.
That's nice, actually.
Yeah, she made it home. Something bad's gonna happen, though. Yeah, exactly. He was just saying he was coming, and then he, you know, went a different route. Oh, born in the shadows.
Very interesting. So they're kind of giving us an idea of where we're at with King of the Monsters, where Monarch is actually testifying in front of the congressional hearing. I honestly don't know Butler at this point. It doesn't make sense. I don't know if they just couldn't get Ken Watanabe back for this, but it seems they've mentioned Sarazawa, but it doesn't look like anyone's updated him that there was a Godzilla sighting. So who knows what's going on?
Well, and we also said before that Monarch seems kind of fractious right now. There's a lot of things at play.
Oh, here we go.
Let's be fortunately.
Whoa, what's going on here? Man.
Still in her brother's room, bro? What the heck?
Yeah, damn.
That's all messed up.
Cake kind of sucks.
Yeah.
Apex. I think that's totally what he's doing, dude.
Yeah. Doesn't heat attract that creature, though?
Unless they already took it out, but...
Wow, Trey, you got that one.
Oh, wow, there it is. Oh, ho, 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 ho,
ho. That's hard. Oh my god. Oh my god.
That's exactly what he's trying to do.
Close it up, right?
Yep.
Hey.
Wow.
Whoa.
Trey was right. Hashtag Trey was right.
Trey was right.
Trey was right again.
Cool.
Wow.
Very. That was a cool episode. I'm not going to lie.
Wow. Yeah, I liked it. At first, I was like, not sure, but it built up.
Whew. There is a lot to unpack for that episode. Obviously, we saw the connection to Godzilla versus Kong with Apex Cybernetics and how they're starting the program of Mecha Godzilla. And it seems, who knows how long, well, actually, if it was almost 3 years ago, they were already applying this technology at some point, or at least seeing some of the implications of it, and then it leading to the idea of when G-Day happens to go, like, well, we could use that as a weapon against, you know, to be the dominant species again. We can't let Godzilla be the one in control, you know. We have to be the apex predator. So, interesting, very interesting. KoJ, your thoughts?
Yeah, I liked him now. He's cool. He's won me over. I'm very happy that it wasn't what I was hoping it wasn't going to be.
Mm.
Like, I'm glad I was wondering if it'd be, because I was wondering if they were going to do a Kentaro episode, or is really heavy on him and not much progression of the actual story going on. But I think the balance of, like, will the real May stand up, and with the progression of the story and what Shaw was doing, we got like 3 or 4 multiple story progressions going on in this. And I like that. It was layered. So it was just, wasn't hard on like one story. So I think that's pretty cool. I'm just curious how, because now we got like, what, 2 more episodes left?
3.
Oh, 3.
8, 9, 10. Yep. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I wonder what they're setting us up for now.
Yeah. I'm very curious, because, like, to me, it's, so we have the Hollow Earth portals, they're closing them, and obviously some Titans are going to be, it's interesting to see how far they'll get with it, because, I mean, Kong has a Hollow Earth portal, so how are they going to get past him? I mean, even Godzilla has his Hollow Earth portal that takes him to his temple, so I don't know. It's a lot of interesting stuff going on. Corey, your initial thoughts?
Man, I liked that the episode picked up quite a bit. A lot of crazy stuff went down. I love Shaw, man. Shaw was the highlight for me of the series, closing the portals, the hostile to Shaw takeover. I enjoyed that quite a bit. May's or Korra's story was fascinating as well. It was fun to watch that play out. But man, that last portion, I didn't like the Kate May thing, especially seeing Kentaro just looking back there, man. Like,
that was messed up, you know?
It was messed up.
Bro. It is, like, yeah. I don't like where they're going, bro, with that. I hope that's just like, it's just a friend theme. But if they turn that into a whole relationship, I'm like, this is going to be some of the weirdest, like,
third wheel. I'm going to be a little ticked off a little bit, yeah.
Thing going on of them just trying to create drama, which I feel like we don't need, like, as Red Hooded Outlaw said, we don't really need relationship drama at the moment. We already have an interesting relationship drama. They're, you know what it is? It's like they're really trying to mirror the issues of the Legacy cast. You know? And to me, it's like I personally don't feel like we need to do the mirroring thing in that aspect. Like, yes, we do have our trio, but at the same time, it's kind of like it's if you're just like rehashing it, then it's just an old story that we've already started to kind of see with the legacy cast. Yes. You're just replaying it, you know.
Yes, but the love triangle with the legacy cast is 100% different than what's going on here. If that this is how it plays out, so
we also did
Shaw and Kiko. They tried. Didn't work out, and then her and Randa get, you know, are together a lot, you know. It kind of bugs me because Kentaro and Korra never really had a closure from what I've seen so far, so like there's still feelings there, so it's like it's just a weird love triangle, and I'm not digging it.
Yeah,
maybe it's not, but
it could be. Yeah, I mean, we haven't
the
seen
way
anything
they
go down.
Shot, but to be honest with you, the way they shot Kentaro looking at it kind of upset. This is what they're trying to put in our head. So this was done purposeful, and you know, I think the other thing too that makes it a little bit weird is Kentaro and Kate are half brother sister. That's, you know, some weird drama going on there, because Kentaro was once there, you know. Is Kate going to show up there as well too, you know? Like, just weird to me.
We'll have to see where they go. I mean, to me, that portion of the story, it's like unneeded for their drama. Like, we already have like enough kind of drama that's pulling us, that it just feels like a weird character arc that like I'm not really interested in them moving forward with. I just kind of want to continue on with learning more about the Apex stuff, the, you know, closing the hollow portal Earth stuff, you know, seeing where that leads. Shaw's story.
Shaw's storyline is the best part of this so far. Like, yeah. It's really taken off. I'm full on with Shaw, you know. Like, let's close these holes up and see where that takes us.
Yeah.
And when are we gonna
of course working for Apex, right?
Yes,
in a way, yes. So, I mean, technically she was working with AET, but
yeah. So how sincere is her affection if that's going in a love triangle era? Maybe that's fake, so she could get closer to Kate.
To just betray them again. It's an interesting thought.
But that right there too is I think the other hard thing that we're seeing right now is with the legacy cast. Those three people all genuinely cared about each other and had a mission, and were focused on that mission. Where nowadays with the after G-Day cast, you know, these, you know, especially Kate and Korra, they're a bunch of backstabbers. You know, they like the only one who's, you know, kind of honorable is Kentaro. But like they're constantly, you know, backstabbing each other, you know, flipping sides, backstabbing other characters and stuff like that. So that's a little,
I'm also not a fan of like Kentaro. Like, Kentaro has weirdly gotten worse and worse in each episode for me as a character. Like more and more uninteresting.
Well, they're like, phasing out.
He's following. Like, he's not really.
He's the puppy dog on a leash, kind of in this thing, you know. And it's like a weird thing. Like, just the fact that he had this weird kind of, I guess you could say, arc of like, oh, well, dad just left us. He wouldn't even answer questions. Did you expect him to just stay there? And like, I mean, clearly he was doing something and he was trying to get you guys to leave. So he took off. So it looked to me, it was like a clear, like he's trying to lead Godzilla away, you know, and that he's up to something, you know, and he's clear. He didn't want his kids involved in it. So he's trying to keep them safe. So it just, to me, it's kind of like the immaturity of Kentaro at this age it's kind of getting old with this post G-Day crew that I'm kind of like, I'm not really enjoying it, especially when Kentaro was so heavy about like, we got to find dad, you know, and him being the one that was holding firm, you know, about like, and Ken keeping his dad in a more positive light than Kate, for him to all of a sudden just be like, well, I saw dad, didn't get my answer, so screw him. You know, it's kind of like, seriously, like you were that close and now you give up. Like, it just, to me, that wasn't like a good switch for him, you know.
So I do want to give a shout out to Beyond the Night. He said, subscribe to the Bat Channel and give them a like. Appreciate that, Beyond the Night.
Absolutely. And replay crew, let us know what you guys think as you're watching this episode. Tell us like how you're feeling about certain scenes, the Apex connection with Walter Simmons, you know, and even May's backstory. Was it satisfying to kind of learn answers finally, or was it kind of just meh? I'd be curious to hear what you guys think. But definitely this Saturday, we're going to be doing our discussion video probably around the same time, 2 p.m. Eastern, with our Monarch Monstars panel.
We may have to talk about that.
Oh, okay. Yeah, well, all right. Well, to be discussed about the Monarch
Monstars panel. It will happen Saturday. Might just happen maybe a little bit earlier, Trey.
Earlier, later? Or is it? Okay. Well, earlier, or later. Keep an eye out for it. We'll send out you know, the notification so you guys can hit that notification bell. Kojay, do you have anything coming up on your show? I know you did some Snyder Cut Fighters last night. I loved it.
Yeah, that was wild. I'm just doing more of that content. But yeah, the one I'm really excited for is the Watch Party series of Super Sentai with you guys. I'm hoping to put a trailer thing out tomorrow so you all know how to purchase or... where you could subscribe to watch it with us. And I think I found a place where you could watch it for free that is safe by the company that puts out the DVDs. But more on that soon. But that's going to be fun. It's pretty much a watch party. You guys watch Super Sentai with us watching it, and that's going to be fun. And it's with the Bat Channel, so there's no disappointment already.
Oh, man.
So yeah, check it out.
Damn. Look at that.
You know, we're having a lot of fun with Super Sentai.
I am having so much fun.
I think if one thing that, like, I know some people say when it comes to like reaction or watch parties, that they really enjoy like feeling the like happiness and excitement and just like people like really enjoying the moment. And that's what it feels like every time. It's like Corey and I are like really just having a great time watching it with Kojay on his show. And honestly looking forward to it's getting me back into Power Rangers even more. I just watched the 2017 film to kind of keep my hype up. Bro. Because I was like, man, I couldn't wait for the next episode. But bro, keep an eye out.
I'm so glad you said that, because I just started watching the original Power Ranger series over again. Because I was like, I can't watch Super Sentai without the crew, but I'm like, I'm gonna get some Power Ranger content.
You gotta get some. I love it. Well, guys, keep an eye out for Saturday. Don't forget, tomorrow we are going to be doing our Rebel Moon Part 1, A Child of Fire watch party later that night on Friday. Set your notifications shortly once I set it up, but we're gonna be having a good time. We're gonna do our watch party review of Rebel Moon. It's just going to be a busy weekend right before the holidays. So don't worry, we're not going to say Merry Christmas just yet. So make sure you stick around for more great episodes on the Bat Channel by liking, sharing, subscribing if you haven't already. Go check out Rebel Moon. Go blow it up on Netflix. Keep watching Monarch. It's going to be, we'll see where this goes. A lot of crazy things happening in the Monsterverse. I'm so excited to keep up the watch parties and discussion videos. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Make sure to subscribe to our boy Kojay.
And thanks for watching. Subscribe to these guys.
Oh man.
And thank you so much for everybody. Man, we had like 20-some people in here tonight watching along with us for Monarch Legacy of Monsters. We know Rebel Moon, everybody's super excited for her. But we can't thank you enough, our Monarch Monstars crew coming in. You guys are awesome. We absolutely love you. We love this community. And yeah, man, I tell you what, Trey, like you said earlier, you know, Rebel Moon was something I was really looking forward to. But man, I am becoming a bit of a Godzilla guy now. So it's like, bro, do you know what's been, okay, I have to talk about this right now. Do you know what's been on my head since I saw it the other day, Trey?
What?
Godzilla minus one monochrome, black and white, bro.
They need to bring that here. Oh, it's only been released in Japan, but they need to bring that here to the US. So Toho, if you're watching, bring that here.
Do it now.
All right, guys, we're gonna head out so we're not up way too late watching Rebel Moon. Have a wonderful night. Thank you so much for hanging out with us. Like, share, subscribe, blah 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 blah. I'm your host, Trey, with Super Bro Corey and our boy, Kojay. And don't forget to tune in weekly.
Same bat time.
Same bat channel.
See you later, guys.
And as you guys all saw today, we had a TPP announcement. We're going to just remind you what TPP means. Thank you. Have a good night. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God.
The fireworks. Whoa,
now. You had fireworks show. That was awesome. Did I get Because baby, you're a firework. Now go and watch some TPP.
And now a special message brought to you by the Titan Preparedness Plan.
With the recent spike in Titan sightings circulating on social media, proactive preparation for a Titan emergence event is crucial. A single towering force of nature has the potential to forever alter the lives of millions. It is our mission to help you prepare for that force. The Titan Preparedness Plan is your guide to staying safe in the face of monsters. These are the three steps you need to know. 1. Know before you go. Identify the location of your nearest Titan shelter and practice navigating a Titan evacuation route with your family on a weekly basis. 2. Run and take cover. In the case of a Titan emergence, calmly sprint to the nearest Titan shelter. If your designated shelter is inaccessible or at capacity, seek the basement or lowest floor of a nearby building. 3. Stay informed. Follow any further instruction from local authorities and stay informed using your mobile device, television, or radio. We can't stop a Titan emergence, but we can safeguard our lives. Join us in building a safer, more resilient community. We are here to protect you.